Walking down the aisle is the groom, Richard Kuhn, and his mother, Sandy Anderson. Thank you. And now coming down the aisle is the bride's son-in-law, Jose Tenorio, and he's escorting the mother of the bride, Maria Cruz. Is the granddaughter of the bride, Leilani Tenorio, our flower girl, but today she is spreading bubbles of love.
For the bride. Giving this woman to be joined to this man.
I am.
Come over to the middle.
Give me your flowers.
You may be seated. Family and friends, we have gathered here to share with Richard Kuhn and Migdalia Cruz in the most important times of their lives. In the time they've been together, their love and understanding for each other has grown and has matured. And so today they have decided to enter into a covenant relationship of marriage under God, witnessed by the most important people in their lives, you, their family and friends. I know we're all so happy to be a part of this. And I'm sure everybody's gonna agree with me in saying how beautiful and how handsome the couple look today and how in love they look. I, as her sister, I have no greater honor than to unite them both today. In the years that you have been together, I have never seen my sister more happier and more at peace and more filled with joy than she has been with you, Richard. The Bible says that he that findeth a good wife finds a good thing. So, Richard, I just want to remind you that She, my sister Migdalia, is a good thing.
Yes.
You all have accomplished great things together. You've purchased a home together, you have cars, you have great success with your jobs. But one of the things I personally admire is that you are both one of the best grandparents I have ever seen. My encouragement to you both for this marriage to stay strong is to continue to give even when you don't feel like giving. And to put God as your number one priority in your lives, because the Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 4 and verse 12, "And though one can overpower him who is alone, two can resist him. But a three cord is not quickly broken." Let's bow our heads in prayer as I pray over the couple. Father, your greatest command was to love you and to love each other. You've given marriage as a holy relationship that reflects our relationship with you. Father, I pray you show Richard and Migdalia how to follow your example and to set aside any selfishness and pride and to humbly serve each other. Help them to be of one spirit and of one mind and value each other above themselves, looking out for each other's interests. In the midst of their busy lives, remind them and help them to take the time to love each other deeply from the heart, just as you have loved us. May the love they have for each other be an example to the world of how you love them and gave your life for them. May their marriage be a place where they grow together and lean on you in every situation. Help them to grow and be more like you in every day, having a unity in spirit, being patient, humble, and gentle with each other, and bearing each other's burdens with your love and strength. Fill their marriage with your peace, and may their first response be to come to you together for help. Help them be intentional in spending time together, and protect them from things that will divide them. Father, enable them to forgive each other as you have forgiven them, and allow them to experience greater peace, greater joy, and greater victories in their marriage like never before. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, Richard and Migdalia have personal vows that they will now share with one another.
So I wrote mine down, exactly what I wanted to say. It's such a beautiful day to be surrounded here by family and friends. Although we will say traditional vows, I wanted to take a moment to say a few words. What is the greatest thing about me? She is a kind and gentle soul, loving mother, who is so personable and connects with everyone she meets on a personal level. We have shared 10 years together building a life that I could have never dreamed of. Many people ask, can you find someone that is perfect for you? I am lucky enough to say yes. Your love and support has allowed me to be a better man and experience the love of family. With Jessica and Jacob, and with two beautiful and smart grandkids, and Leilani and Lucas. I look forward to the great things that lie ahead of us. You are my travel partner, my work partner, my everyday partner. Most times I feel like we know what each other is thinking without saying a word. We always seem to be in sync, and sometimes even say the same thing at the same time. Thank you. With all my love today, I am honored to take you to be my wife.
Your boss.
I've known you for 10 years. The younger than 10 is that I love the boy because you not only showed me I can trust again, you showed me what it's about you and everything about you, whether it's about details. Toilet seat, grandchild. You're unique. You're special, loving, You love unconditionally. These have been the best 10 years. You have brought me so much joy. So many help. I love you. And I love you for you. Thank you.
So, Richard, do you, Richard, take Migdalia to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinances in holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, honor her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, and keep only unto her as long as you both shall live from this day forward? You signify by saying,
I do.
I do. To Migdalia, do you, Migdalia, take Richard to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinances in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, honor him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and keep only unto him as long as you both shall live from this day forward? Signify by saying, we're going to do the exchange of our vows now. Repeat after me as you look into your bride's eyes, okay? I, Richard. Take you, Migdalia.
To be my wife.
My partner in my life.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our union.
And love you more each day than I did the day before.
I will trust you.
Respect you.
Laugh with you.
And cry with you.
Loving you faithfully. Through the good and the bad.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
I will continue to place God. As the center of our marriage.
I give you my hand.
My heart.
And my love.
From this day forward.
As long as we both shall live.
Are you ready? To the beautiful bride, I'm Migdalia. Take you, Richard. To be my husband.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our union.
And love you more each day. Than I did the day before. I will trust you. Respect you. Laugh with you. Cry with you. Loving you faithfully through the good and the bad. Regardless of the obstacles we may face. I will continue to place God at the center of our marriage. I give you my hand. My heart. My love. From this day forward. As long as we both shall live. And now we will do the unity sand ceremony.
Thank you.
will seal their vows with the rings. The ring is an endless circle, so let me grab the rings. The ring is an endless circle. There is no beginning and there is no ending. It signifies the love that they will have surrounded by them every day and every day that they live. It also signifies the unity of the families that are coming together. And I know the children and grandchildren are all in agreement with this. So to the groom, Richard, take your ring for her. No, her ring. Give her your ring. As you place the ring on her finger, repeat after me. As a token of our vows, made between us, with this ring, I thee wed. Migdalia, as you place the ring on his finger, repeat after me. As a token of our vows, between us made, with this ring, I thee wed. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 19, verse 5 and 6, "For this reason a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but they are one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." And so I announce, Richard, you may now kiss your bride. Everyone, get your bubbles ready. I would like for you both to face your family and your friends. For as much as Richard and Migdalia have considered together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and have given and pledged their loyalty each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, by joining hands, by the power that is invested in me, by the state of Florida, from the county of Seminole, as a pastor of the Lighthouse Church, ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Richard Kuhn.
Did I get too close? Oh, did I almost see what's really on the inside? All your insecurities, all the dirty laundry, never made me blink one time. Unconditional. Just as you watching me, don't need apologies. Know that you are worthy. I'll take your bad days with your good. Walk through the storm, I would do it all because I love. Unconditionally, I will love you unconditionally. There is no fear, let go and just be free. I will love you
for me.